Hello, I hope you're doing well today. I assume you're here because you're curious whether or not you can build or improve scenery in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. The answer is, you can. This is not a tutorial on building scenery. This is a video showing you the tools needed and to encourage you to give it a try. I will link a playlist that covers many aspects of scenery building and modifications in the description below. You do not have to be a computer expert or brilliant in any field. All that is required is an imagination, desire, and a willingness to work and improve. Age is not a factor. I am considered a senior citizen in the United States, and I have built close to 500 scenery packages over the last 2 years. If you are concerned that you will make a mess of the scenery world, you won't. You can do no harm. All of your actions are confined to a scenery folder in which you are working in. Even after you move the scenery package to the community folder, undoing what you did is as simple as deleting the package. You will do no harm. We are all different, but I get satisfaction from flying over and admiring my work. I have redone some of my earlier scenery work after I improved and now have a better result. It is fairly simple and you will improve with time. If you're still curious, the following chapters will show you the basics of what it takes to build scenery. This video is in chapters, so if you already have basic knowledge, you can go to the description below and view the chapters that you need for understanding. Greetings and welcome to Patriot Six. I make tutorial videos for scenery building or modifications to scenery in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 utilizing SDK. Different people at different levels of skill see these videos. You may be here because you're curious or you may already know the basics of scenery building. It is impossible for me to know who will click on a video. Because of the broad range of folks that view the videos, I include the basics in each video. This and all new videos will be built in chapters. You can find the chapters of the video in the description below. In addition, you can see the chapters on the video timeline if you want to skip the basic chapters. To build scenery in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020, you must be in developer's mode. And this is a very simple process, and I'll walk through it. First, you go to Options, go to General Options, you go to Developers, On, Apply and Save. Once in developer's mode, you will see a menu appear at the top. I refer to this often as the developer's menu. In addition to being in developer's mode, you must have SDK. And this is a very simple process. You go up to the developer's menu, you find the help, you tick on help, and then you tick on SDK Installer Core. And a window will open up and SDK will load in. And from that point, you can decide where you want the SDK. I'm going to tick off of this because I already have it. I put SDK on my C drive and I called the folder MSFS SDK, but you can place SDK where you want to place it. In addition to that, it's always good to go in and get the samples. And from the same help menu, you want to go down to samples. And again, you will download the samples. I'm going to stop it because I already have the samples. And once you download the samples, you can go into your SDK folder that you built. And you can find samples by ticking on the samples folder. And there's all kinds of samples here, but the one most often used is the one called Simple Scenery. Let's talk about the tools that we need to build scenery. In most projects, it's very simple. The items which you use to build scenery are typically in your scenery library already. There are exceptions, though. If you are bringing a 3D model into the sim, that would be an exception. If you are using the Earth to MSFS tool, that is another exception. And on occasion, you may need a text editor. I will explain the reason for the text editor once I do a video where the text editor is needed. For starters, put a folder on your desktop that you will use as your working scenery folder. I have one here and I will show you what I have in it. All I have in it is a simple scenery folder I downloaded from SDK, and I do have a thumbnail. In the simple scenery folders that you download through this version of SDK, a thumbnail is not mandatory because there is a standard thumbnail within the scenery package. However, on all of my projects, I choose to have a thumbnail. And it's your choice where you want to go with a standard thumbnail in the scenery folder, or if you want your own. If you decide you want to make your own thumbnail, the thumbnail has to be the precise dimensions of this thumbnail I use, 412 by 170 pixels. No other size will work. So if you build your own thumbnail, please keep this rule in mind. Let's talk about the developer camera. The developer camera is something that is vital and something that you will use often. And to get to the developer camera, you go up to the developer menu, tick on camera, and tick on developer camera. Operating the developer camera is a lot like operating the drone camera. So I'll show you the keys that we use to operate the developer camera. If we want to drop, we hit the F key. If we want to rise, we hit the R key. If we want to go left, we use the A key. And if we want to go right, we use the D key. If we want to go forward, we use the W key. And if we want to go in reverse, we use the S key. There's also some numerical keys that you can use. On the number pad, the 4 key will spin you. And the 6 key will spin you in the opposite direction. The 8 key will tilt your camera up. And the 2 key will tilt your camera down. Occasionally when you're building scenery, your azimuth will get off. So that's very easy to correct by using the 7 key or the 9 key. And then you can correct your azimuth. You can also use the mouse and freely move around. By holding down the left Alt key and by using your left mouse button, you're able to move anywhere you want to move. Also, you can use the mouse wheel to zoom in or out. Almost always, this is a process I go through. I'll tick on the developer camera. I will drop to the ground using the F key. Then I will use the left Alt key and the left mouse button to make sure I can spin in small areas. That is the fine control of the camera I'm looking for. What I don't want is this. You see what happened there? As soon as I got in and I used my mouse button to move, look how far I am from my aircraft. So again, to the developer camera, drop down with the F key, and with the left Alt key depressed and the left mouse button, make sure you can make minute movements. And now you're good to go and ready to use the developer camera.